joining us, associate head coach of the Cavalier baseball team, Brandon Costa. Coach, this has to feel just like a whirlwind to you. You've played one game, and now we're going into conference play this weekend with a four-game set at Tusculum. I guess briefly just try to talk about how you've tried to get the guys ready to play conference games with just one game under your belt and very little practice time due to this weather.
Yeah, it's been a challenge, but I think one good thing, you know, playing at LMU, you know, they have a great facility there, great turf facility. So it was our first time actually on a baseball field since we came back in January from Christmas break. So you could kind of see a different energy during pregame, during BP, during IO, once we were at the field there and able to work on some things. But I think one thing that's helped the last 2 days, we were able to get on our field. We were able to pull the tarp before the rain came in earlier this week, and we were out there Tuesday and Wednesday, which was good. We got a lot of stuff done. So I think that got the guys excited and ready to go for this weekend rolling into conference play. But, you know, it's a challenge. It's always a challenge every year. This year was a little bit tougher, but, you know, being in the mountains, you know, you kind of figure it out inside, and they've been doing a good job inside as well. But I think having our time outside this week, just the 2 days, has kind of got the guys going a little bit.
Coach, going into a weekend series, we talked about a little bit in the preseason when you and I spoke, 32 scheduled innings on the mound you have to take care of, and you don't have a guy on this staff yet who's thrown more than, say, 35 pitches in a game. How are you and pitching Coach McCown attacking this weekend and making sure, you know, you keep guys safe and healthy and still competitive in the game as well?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's one of those things where I said last week we devised a plan and try to follow as close as possible, and we're going to continue to do that. We did that at LMU. Granted, it was only one nine-inning game, but the pitchers that we put out there against LMU, they did their job. They threw competitive strikes. They were in the zone. They were out there competing. So for this weekend, you know, we're just going to have to stick to our plan. You know, the guys that I named last week during the interview, Christian Smith, Garrett Stiltner, you know, those are two guys that we're going to kind of have in those starting roles. And then from there, we have some guys that have really started to, you know, kind of come up through the ranks a little bit, I guess you could say, as some relief guys that we can put in there for two, maybe three innings. Definitely have some solid one inning guys in there. So, you know, with that many innings on the weekend, like we said before, we're going to sit down, devise a plan, and follow it as close as possible. And we told the pitching staff that it's all hands on deck. So when your name gets called, because it will get called this year because of the amount of innings we're playing in 2 days, you just go out there, do your job. Go out there, throw competitive strikes, you know, try to leave the situation better than you found it type of deal, and go out there and have a good inning or two.
First collegiate game for anyone. I think the butterfly's got to be rolling. Justin Reed, first collegiate game. He comes in. Nobody reaches base safely against him, local kid from Nicholsville. Talk about him and maybe his role going in the weekend and what you saw from him in that one inning.
Yeah, that was, Justin Reed, great way to describe him is he's a competitor. Doesn't matter if it's on the offensive side or the defensive side or the pitching side of the baseball, he's going to find a way to beat you. That's what he tries to do. So was I shocked at his body of work? No, because I know what type of kid he is. Was I shocked that that's how he went about his business in his first collegiate appearance, especially on the mound? Yeah, a little bit. Just because he is a freshman, first college appearance, and he did a great job. So for him, you know, it's going to be one of those things where he's going to be, you know, definitely a guy out of the bullpen for us now. He's kind of solidified that role a little bit, but also going to be a guy that we can put at third base, you know, because he can swing it a little bit, play a little bit of third. With these amount of innings on the position player side, our guys are going to need some breaks here and there. And so he's definitely won a role on the mound, in my opinion. And, you know, he did an absolutely great job against LMU. He just went out there and competed. So it was really good to see that.
Offensively in that one game against LMU, only five hits, but you did work six walks at the plate. Really thought situational hitting and cashing some guys in. We had opportunities. Maybe some missed opportunities. Speak on that a little bit and how you need to improve there going into league play.
Yeah, so that was the biggest thing from the LMU game was situational hitting, hitting with runners in scoring position, hitting with runners on base. You know, we were able to get them on, but we were not able to capitalize. And that was a product of you know, you can use the excuse of it being a first game, whatever. I don't really buy it too much because we do have an older lineup. I could see maybe the first time up, maybe even the first two times up in the game, you try to do that. And then at some point, you got to make an adjustment. And that's what we lacked. It wasn't that, you know, our lineup doesn't know how to hit, how to situational hit, or our lineup doesn't know what they have to do with the runner in scoring position. They know what they're doing. They just let the situation get the better of them a little bit. And in practice, you know, that's what we worked on. From the offensive standpoint, we worked on situational hitting, being able to get outside. Like I said earlier, we're able to have base runners out there with the defense and have them see, you know, kind of what it's supposed to look like. So on that side of it, we really worked on that after the LMU game, just so guys could get reps and see that side of it. Because like I said, they know what to do. It's just a matter of executing and just, you know, not changing anything, just trying to put the ball and play hard somewhere and see what happens. So, you know, we talked about it, worked on it. So I'm expecting that adjustment to be made this weekend against Tusculum.
Coach, final question for you, maybe a little bit too early, may not have spoke. You're neither one are meteorologists, but the weather looks pretty bad. Looks like there's a lot of rain coming in. What are the rules this year with COVID and playing four games? If one of these days gets banged in terms of can you make it up? When do you make it up? Just so that the people watching this know, maybe if weather comes, what the schedule could look like.
Yeah, so right now, potentially, I'll just tell you right now, potentially playing a single nine tomorrow and then going to try to play a doubleheader Saturday. So that is what it's looking like right now. We're still not 100% sure. We'll find out more tomorrow morning with the forecast and everything, but that's what it is, what it's looking like right now, because Sunday and Monday is looking pretty rough. So we're going to try to get as many games in as we can Friday, Saturday, with a single nine tomorrow and possibly a doubleheader Saturday. So you know, that's kind of what we're looking at right now. We just got to wait and see the forecast until tomorrow morning.
Fans, stay tuned to uvawisecavs.com. As soon as we get the information on the schedule, that'll be posted. Coach, thank you for your time. As always, good luck this weekend, and hopefully we can beat the Pioneers and Mother Nature.
Yeah. Appreciate it, Daryl. You have a good one.
Same. Thanks.